back, guys. It's Diwali, and we are in conversation with some of the top fund managers of the country to find out what the mood is like this Diwali and how you should approach it between this Samvat and next.
You know, the one big sector which has done really well from last Samvat to this Samvat is the IT space. The entire IT pack has done really well. The index itself is up some 35%. Is the big tailwind behind all these IT companies now, given that rupees now back to 73 or 72.5? And if US slows down, probably there will be a growth concerns as well. What is your view on the IT at this point in time? Should one look to book out of IT?
So I'm kind of cautious on that space because, as I said, I do think that the US is growing above trend. I mean, the long-term growth in US is 2%. Right now, it's growing at 3%. And when that happens, you have to be cautious about an economy. So given that if US slows down, the stocks have done 50-100% over last 18 months, I'd be kind of cautious on the space. The other part is, at least if you look at large caps, the market caps are so high that for them to become multi-bagger is not very easy. So I think there are a lot of other sectors where India's market cap is quite low, which I think will do relatively better from here.
Likes of?
So as I said, at least in the mid-cap space, I see a host of industries which are asset-based and where stocks are close to book value. So whether you take utilities, cement, real estate, textiles, a lot of these segments, and I think the value style, since it was not in favor, a lot of these stocks are cheap. And if either there is an acceleration of growth or deceleration of growth, because what will happen is if there is acceleration of growth, these guys will have earnings upgrades and will do well. And I think if there's any disappointment globally, the well-owned stocks, which are growth stocks, they may suffer more.
You know, I was just looking at some data, and historically in India, the space which has really created a lot of wealth for investors is the consumption basket. I was looking at the Motilal Oswal's 23rd study, and all the 10 wealth creators, fastest wealth creators, came from the consumption space, whether it's Maruti or the Maricos of the world or the Dabos of the world. It always been expensive. What is your take on the consumption basket? Should one still look to buy those stocks? Nilesh, first you.
So one, on the consumption side, valuations have already corrected. Second, some amount of discretionary consumption is coming under pressure. The NBFCs won't be able to provide easy credit for automobiles or for consumer durables. And to that extent, sales will get impacted. So we will see some amount of corrections in consumption-related stories, and that's where one can wait to get the right price to get into the stocks. On the other hand, there are some consumer stories where for last 2-3 years they had stagnated. They were not driven by leverage, they were driven by actual consumption. The growth was looking patchy compared to leveraged consumption. Now those sectors, those companies, those items could be at the breakout level. So I think it's time to move away from leveraged consumption to non-leveraged consumption.
Okay, got that. Since we have very little time left on the show, what we're going to do is try and like make it a bit more fun. Enough of the market talk, the advice. Now we're going to do a little rapid fire with you guys. Not going to give you too much time to answer. So very quickly, Amit, first to you. Which is the one stock or two stocks which was your biggest hit and biggest miss between last Samvat and now?
In the last Samvat and this Samvat?
Yeah.
In the last 1 year.
I mean, there would be several of those. I think if you see the carnage that has happened in the mid and small cap space, there are so many stocks that have fallen 30% and 40%. But thankfully for us, there are a lot of other stocks that have made up for it. I mean, identifying one or two, there are so many.
Oh, you this can't huge give me a divergence. Politically correct answer. You have to tell me the biggest stock mistake name, you made. The biggest
there's a huge point. Divergence in performance. I mean, if you look at Nifty, if you remove the top 9 stocks, the remaining 41 stocks, Nifty is flat, YTD. But the stocks, I mean, the index is down 15% if you remove the 9 stocks.
Okay, what about you, Manish?
So for us, call on pharma went pretty okay 1 year back. Some of the IT stocks did pretty okay. Where we went wrong is industrials, because to be honest, we didn't expect this kind of rupee depreciation and volatility in the macro, because the crude spike was kind of unexpected. So those are the hits and misses we've had.
Nilesh, your hits and misses?
So success came from IT, failure came from NBFC space.
Okay.
Success came in large cap, failure came in small cap.
Okay, that's good to hear.
All three of you all, in terms of ranking, small and mid cap, micro cap, or large cap, your first preference?
1 year return point.
One year from a 1 year point of view. This to next number.
Small caps will do well.
Micro caps?
Micro caps, you have to be really choosy, and if by micro caps you mean those small exchanges, I have no idea. I don't track them.
Okay, so small caps will do well. What about you?
Small and mid caps. Basically, a multi-cap fund over a large-cap fund now.
Okay. And you?
It seems to be a consensus, small and mid-cap.
You've been saying that for a while. Your fund has done phenomenally
well. Last year, I mentioned that. For 4 years, our view was that small and mid-caps would outperform large-cap. But I think last Diwali, there is a lot of froth in valuation now. You need to be careful for next 1 year. But I think that froth has got cleaned up quite a bit.
Okay, so guys, if you are looking to buy something, then perhaps putting money in a small and mid-cap fund is the best thing to do. Next, what's your biggest stress buster?
Spending time with my daughter.
Okay, yours?
Same, plus playing badminton.
Playing, what do you play?
Badminton.
Oh, lovely. Okay, and
Amit?
Meditation.
Okay. You also meditate, you do yoga. I thought you would say yoga is your stress buster.
That's the second stress buster. When my daughter gives stress, then I have to miss that.
Okay. In the next 1 year from now, Nifty, down 10%, up 10%, all three of you?
I think up 10% plus.
Manish?
Very difficult to give short-term targets, but 3 years definitely double.
1 year. It's not short-term, 1 year.
1 year, I don't know. 3 years double digit.
Okay. What about you?
10% plus if you are lucky and sensible, 10% down if you are unlucky and unsensible.
This is very diplomatic.
you give me.
Yeah, what do you say?
I would say 10% plus regardless of anything.
This is the bold call.
Unless there is a large, so let's say if oil goes to 100, if there is a trade war which really blows out of proportion, that's a different thing altogether. Okay. But otherwise, I think 10% plus regardless of anything in domestic economy.
So he's really putting his money where his mouth is.
This is best of Namit. Last year he said, avoid small caps. This year is saying buy small caps, small and mid cap funds.
And the market will go up
10% from here. Wow.
You have to stick your neck out.
So we all three said buy small cap, no doubt about it. All I'm putting is a caveat so that next Diwali you'll invite me back to the show.
I will invite you nevertheless.
You could say him, I won't invite you if you're wrong. But I will be right either ways.
You may not get invited to Diwali Pujas, but you'll definitely get invited to our show for sure. Manish, what about you in terms of, say, you know, pockets that have fallen a lot, like, say, NBFCs, we've gotten hit the hardest, some of the infrastructure companies. Do you see a revival or are these spaces not to touch at all? One word answer.
No, definitely I see a revival. I think there is genuine need for some good companies there. So the good companies will bounce back a lot.
Okay, and you've burnt your fingers in NBFCs, but would you touch them again?
Undoubtedly. I have put my debt money as well as equity money on them. But clearly, we will now be a little bit more cautious in approaching this sector. Clearly, we have to invest in those NBFCs whose liability franchise is strong. We were more looking at asset side growth and quality of asset, but liability franchise is also necessary.
Okay.
Well, I have something funny to ask all three of you all. Next World Cup, can India win again? Namrit, are you betting on India to win the World Cup?
You're talking 2019? About cricket?
Yeah, cricket World Cup.
I don't follow much, so I'm not an expert.
Okay, then I'll ask you something else. Manish?
Typically, lightning doesn't strike twice, so okay. I'll be doubtful.
Nilesh?
Undoubtedly, India will be winner by a margin.
Wow, great. The second question to all three of you all. Modi and Trump getting re-elected, all three of you all, your answers.
I don't think so.
For both?
Sorry?
Modi and Trump getting re-elected?
Oh, Modi and Trump. That's a difficult call. Trump, I'm relatively more, I think, confident, unlikely. Okay. Yeah. Which will be very different because I think last several presidents in US, they've got re-elected.
Correct.
History might change. Let's
Manish?
See.
Whatever mass media says, I mean, we read the same newspapers. Yeah.
No, but your gut
feel. Correct answer.
No, I have no insight to add.
But your gut feel. It's just a fun.
The newspapers are saying probability is more than 50%. So I'll go with that.
Nilesh?
So to the extent my vote can make a difference, I'm going to vote for Mr. Trump also.
Okay.
Okay. And one finally before we let you all go, since you're all in this mood of giving us, you know, your telling us what your heart is saying, one stock for the, say, the next 10 years, one large cap stock, which one would it be?
We are not allowed to give stock specific tip as per SEBI regulation. But Kotak Blue Chip Fund, you can take it. It will give you diversified large caps.
I thought you would do better than that. What about you?
Nice try. Can't comment.
Okay, one sector. That is a sector of the next 10 years.
10 years.
Oh, 5 years?
I think large corporate banks.
Corporate banks. Wow. Okay, that's a big call. What about you?
I also think so. Also, I think there are a lot of opportunities even in the industrial space. It's been a tough time for the last few years. But I think those who have built assets in India over the last few years, think about it, a few years back, rupee was 50 and it's 75. Your cost has gone up 50% and so are most of the other costs. It's not easy to put up good quality assets. And those who have really streamlined their operations, have built their balance sheets, I think they will do well.
Okay, and Nilesh, what about you, the sector for the long term?
Supply chain disruption. This is Y2K of India's IT.
Okay, well, on that note, happy Diwali to all of you, to your families, to your teams at work. We hope next Diwali when we speak, things will be a lot better than it is right now. On that note, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. And do stay tuned in. Lots more coming up on the markets, on the festive season and all the news. Stay tuned.